Hi guys, co-tutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande. In this particular video, I am going to revisit Parcelable concept. I already have a video on how to use the Parcelable and why we are supposed to use a Parcelable instead of serializable. If you are not familiar with these things, I would request you to stop this video, go back to the link provided and come back here. So in this video, instead of concentrating on why we are supposed to use Parcelable, I will continue it further and we will be mainly concentrating on how to parcel different types of data types other than the string, which we have already covered in the previous video. So without much further ado, let me directly get into the coding. So if you have observed the previous video, in that case, I have already used these three string data types, that is first name, last name and qualification, and you already know how to parcel them. And in this case, I will be dealing with different types of data types, like what if I want to use an enumerated data type? What if I want to deal with an array of string, that is a list of strings? And how do I parcel a Boolean data type? And what if I want to parcel a custom array? In this case, I have created another class called as city lived in, which basically contains the city name and date object. And that city lived in also implements the parcelable interface. You can observe that this date is being stored into the parcel by get time. So it is getting converted into a long data type. So you can see write long. That is how it gets returned to the parcel. And in the same way, you can read it back by using read long and converting it back to the date object. How do I deal with a gender? In this case, I have created it to be of type enumerated. So let us get started with reading these different data types. Assume that I have a height, which is of type int, that can be accessed by parcel.readInt. So that will return me an int data type. And if I have something like qualifications, which is of a list of string, that can be got by parcel.readArrayList. And you can pass on the null. So it will give me the array of strings, which in this case is qualifications. And then I have a gender. Gender is an enumerated data type. So it's up to now for you to decide how do you want to convert this enumerated data type so that it becomes easily a parcelable.
What I am basically doing is I am writing it as a byte, and if it is one, then I am interpreting it as male, and if it is zero, I am interpreting it as a female. I could have written it as a serializable also, but once again, what is the whole purpose of using parcelable? To avoid using serializable. So that is why read byte, and then if it is equal to one, it is treated as a male enumeration type, else it is female. And then I have a Boolean data type. Once again, I am going to treat Booleans as byte values. I could have used int also, but I am using byte because it is of much shorter length compared to int. So this dot hostile preference. And once again, I will say parcel dot read byte equal to one. Then I am going to return true, else it is going to be false. I am just using a ternary operator. And what if I want to read an array of custom data types? In this case, it is a list of a city lived in. This can be done by a method called as create typed array list. This dot resident history is equal to parcel dot create typed array list. And as you can see, it takes a creator as the argument, and what basically we have to pass is creator of city lived in. So city lived in dot creator, and this is basically going to give me the array list of residence history. I have only shown you how to read it. Now we will write the complementary part, which is actually writing it. So in case of height, parcel dot write int this dot height, that is going to write the height into the parcel. Next is the qualifications. Qualifications is a array list of strings, and that can be written with the method write list. So parcel dot write list, and pass on the list that you want to write to the parcel. I now need to write the gender. I have to once again interpret a one being male and a zero being female, or anything other than one being a female. So for that, parcel dot write byte this dot gender. If it is equal to male, then I am going to interpret it as one, and if it is zero, if it is going to be female. Hostile preference, which is of Boolean type, that is pretty easy. Once again, I will be writing write byte and this dot hostile preference. If it is equal to true, then byte value 1, else it is going to be byte value 0. Now comes the remaining part, that is residence history. That can be written using a method called as write typed list. So parcel dot write typed list, and pass on the array list that you want to store. I will run this particular code in the debug mode. In the second activity, I have created a breakpoint so that I can pause it here and show the value of the person that I am passing from my first activity, which is main activity. You can see that I am basically setting all different values over here, and in the second activity, what I will get is the person back. I can see that it is get parcelable extra. So let me run it in the debug mode. So let me click on this particular button, and as you can see, because I have put a breakpoint here, the application will pause. I just want to check what is the value of the expression of the person. It is exactly the values that I have sent from the main activity. So I had sent a mail there, 1. So it gets interpreted as parcelable byte value 1. And height is 6. I have sent the value of height as 6. Last name, qualification, these are string data types. It's a array list of string, qualifications, resident history, which are once again array of city lived in objects. So you can see the city and date, which are once again a parcelable object. So it is a array of parcelable object. That's how you basically parcel different types of data types in Android. That brings us to the end of this particular video. If you have got any questions, please post them in the comment section below. Subscribe to the channel and let me know any new topics that you would be interested in, so that I can take up that particular topic for the next video. Take care. Bye.